Moving into a new house can be demanding. One can quickly become overwhelmed by the task of packing up your entire life and moving it all to a new location. I'm sure many of you are wondering what to do before you close on your house. And that's why I'm sharing my top 10 things to do before you move into your new home. And just so you know, I've been a realtor for over 15 years and I've personally guided more than 500 people through the home buying process. I've also closed on multiple homes for myself, so you can trust that I won't leave anything important out. Hi, I'm Ty the Real Estate Guy, and if you'd like to stay up to date on latest real estate tips and trends, subscribe to my channel below and ring that little bell. If you have questions or comments at any time during this video, please leave a message below. I'll do my best to respond to each one of you. If you're looking to buy, sell, or build a home in Utah, please feel free to call or text. I would love to talk with you. Also, you're gonna wanna watch to the end because I'm gonna make some recommendations that are sure to answer your other real estate related questions. Now, I'm excited to kick off my 250th video by helping those of you who are closing on your very own home. If you've watched my other videos, you know that I'm a huge proponent of home ownership, so congratulations. But moving can be stressful and it's often overwhelming. You'll spend days or often weeks packing up your entire life, and then just a few days later, you're unpacking and trying to arrange everything. That alone is enough to overwhelm most people physically, mentally, and emotionally. Many of you are leaving the town that you were raised in, really the only place you've ever called home, and you're headed to an unfamiliar location, which can be terrifying. The process of moving from one place to another is chaotic, but if you're prepared, the move should go smoothly. So I'm gonna simplify the process by sharing my checklist for what to do before you close on your home. The goal is to help you avoid the common mistakes I often see people make when buying a home. So let's get started. Number one, de-junk. Before you start packing, go through every room in the house, including the garage, and get rid of everything you no longer need. You can have a yard sale or listings online and make a little extra money, or donate your old things. I like to ask my friends and family first, or just throw it away. Do not make the mistake of tossing everything into boxes with the intention of organizing and throwing things out when you get to the new house. I'm telling you, it's gonna add a lot of unnecessary stress. Think about it. Why would you wanna pack, move, and then unpack things that you're just gonna get rid of? You could end up with several additional boxes of junk that you didn't need to carry to the new property. Not only is this a huge waste of time, but it could increase your cost. Moving to a new home should be viewed as a fresh start and a great opportunity to get rid of some old things that should probably be replaced anyway, or that you just don't use anymore. Seriously, what's the point of moving an old mattress or couch if you're just gonna replace it in the next year or two? Remember that one man's trash is another man's treasure, so you may be able to really help someone less fortunate by waving bye-bye to some of those old things. Number two, packing. Boxes can be expensive, so before you spend a small fortune on cardboard, think outside the box. Do you see what I did right there? Think outside the box. I know, it's stupid, sorry. Anyway, to save money, I'd start by asking neighbors. I'm a huge fan of using the Facebook neighborhood page, or ask friends and family if they know someone who has recently moved if they might be willing to give you some of their boxes. Or stop by local business or retailers that may give you boxes. Walmart gave me more boxes than I could use. You can also use garbage bags, suitcases, laundry baskets, and things of that nature. Be creative, but always, always, always. I'm trying to drive a point home, so I hope you're paying attention. Always label the boxes. Unpacking will be a nightmare if you skip this one simple step. Purchase one of those fat Sharpies and write on top of every box or bag where you want that particular package to be delivered when you arrive to the new home. When it comes time to unpack, this will save you loads of time and stress. Before the moving truck arrives at the new home, take some sticky notes and write things like master bedroom, kitchen, office, bedroom one, bedroom two, bedroom three, and etc. Then affix these sticky notes to the appropriate locations in the new house. So when the moving truck arrives, You and anyone who might show up to help will know exactly where to put the boxes. Do not skip this step because family, friends, and neighbors might show up to help you unload. I also recommend posting that you're moving on your neighborhood Facebook page, Instagram, or wherever. Give friends and family the date and time so if anyone wants to help, they know where to go and what time to be there. Post this information 2 times, once a few days before you move, and again the night before or the morning of the move. Maybe throw it out there that you have pizza for anyone who's willing to help. Food is a great motivator, but it's also an inexpensive way to show your gratitude for those who took time out of their busy lives to come help you. Sorry, I know the second step is getting long, but I have one more recommendation. Pack one special box and don't let it out of your sight. This is your box of essentials that will help you survive the first 24 hours. This will be things like your toothbrushes, toothpaste, deodorant, makeup, and etc. This will also include snacks, pajamas, and a fresh change of clothes. Number 3, organize and secure important documents. First, find a safe place to store your important documents during the move. I keep everything of importance in a safe, so I might ask a close friend or a family member if I could leave the safe with them during the move. If you're not comfortable doing that, you might have a secure place at work, or you can get a safety deposit box. These important documents might include things like your tax returns, social security cards, birth certificates, medical and insurance information, and etc. When you're doing this, there's a good chance you'll find documents that are no longer needed, but have information that you probably don't want in the wrong hands. Destroy these documents. You can shred them, burn them, or both if it makes you feel better. Number 4, set up your utilities. Look up the different providers in the new location that you're moving to and let them know your move-in date. Some of these companies could be scheduled out a few days or even weeks, so you want to let them know as soon as possible. By the way, is this your first house? If so, I bet you don't even know who to call. Am I right? Well, you have water, electricity, gas, and don't forget the city. Yeah, you've got to pay them on a weekly basis too. So I would start by calling the city office. Usually, they can tell you who to contact. Often, the city manages some of these services anyways, and they often manage things like recycling and garbage removal. Number 5, set up internet and television. Once again, this is something that you'll want to schedule weeks before your move-in date, especially if you work from home. If you forget, you might find yourself sitting in McDonald's using the free Wi-Fi to get some work done, or driving to a restaurant to watch the big game. Because so many of us work from home these days, not having the internet could be a very bad thing. You could easily spend an hour researching who the best providers are and who's the best deal. So you may want to start by calling your current provider. They may be able to transfer your service to the new property, or switch to YouTube TV and just take it wherever you want. No, I was not paid to say that, but I do highly recommend it. Now, can I ask you a quick favor? Will you please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel below? I would appreciate it more than you know, and it'll help others see that this video is helpful. And it allows me to produce more videos like this one to help awesome people just like you. Thank you. Number 6, update your address. This is something that a lot of people forget to do. And even for those that remember, frequently someone or something is missed. So start a list of all the companies who send bills, subscriptions, prescriptions, or whatever, and keep it somewhere visible like the bathroom mirror or the fridge so you can easily add to the list when needed. I would start at the post office and have them forward your mail to the new address. Carefully consider all the companies that send you things on a regular basis. Things like credit cards, banks, insurance companies, Amazon.com, and etc. The list can be long and it can be time consuming, but you don't want your deliveries going to the old address or personal information in the wrong hands. Number 7, take a few days off. If possible, schedule some days off at work. Usually one weekend isn't enough to unload all the boxes and set everything up. The kitchen alone can take an entire day to unpack and organize. You'll probably also want to be present for the deliveries or services that you've ordered. One of my clients forgot that a washer and dryer was coming, and when they finally got the message, it was too late. The delivery company left the washer and the dryer sitting on the driveway. This nice young couple not only had to install the washer and dryer themselves, which is a pain in the butt, but they also had to ask friends to to help them carry them up the stairs, of course scraping and dinging the walls of their brand spanking new home. Even though my beautiful wife is more than capable, I'm not comfortable leaving her alone in the house with a stranger, even if they are 5-star rated. I love that girl, and I would never forgive myself if something bad happened. Moving into a new home should be magical, and if you have that special someone, it's a great opportunity to spend some time together. One final thought, if you have kids, see if a friend or family member can watch them for a few hours or even days while you organize and put things together. Number 8, schedule services. If you're moving into an older or existing house, you'll probably want the home cleaned professionally before you move in. I highly recommend it. I mean, some people are just dirty. And I would bet, at least for most of you, that the previous homeowners did not clean the house to your standards. And if the previous homeowners had pets, you should have the carpet professionally cleaned as well. If the carpet is more than a few years old, I would just replace it. You don't want your baby crawling around on a floor where someone's dog has peed, right? And if you think about remodeling or doing some repairs, you might want to give yourself a few extra days after the previous homeowners have left so you can get a lot of work done before you move in. Some repairs can be messy, and if you're wanting to paint, you'll want to do that ahead of time as well. All those boxes and the furniture will just get in your way and slow you down. Number 9, take lots of pictures. It's wise to photograph anything of value before you start packing, especially if you're using a moving company. Why? Because that company will repair or replace anything that gets lost, broken, or damaged, especially if you can prove it. And chances are, something's going to get ruined while you're moving from point A to point B. But even if you're not using a moving company, I still recommend photographing everything because if something important breaks or gets damaged while making the move, your insurance company may replace it. When taking photos, it's best to use your smartphone because phones these days take extremely high quality pictures, plus they'll put a time and date stamp on the picture. If you're worried or you're moving things of great value, you may consider moving insurance. Number 10, get to know the surrounding area. Google Maps is awesome for this, but you'll want to spend some time researching the local businesses and public services. This can be anything from the nearest grocery store to schools, the hospital, or restaurants. Because the best doctors, pediatricians, hairdressers, and etc. are usually scheduled out weeks or months in advance, you might even want to make some appointments. There are great sites to read reviews or do research like Google or Yelp, but I recommend joining the Facebook page for the neighborhood that you're moving into and asking your future neighbors and friends who they'd recommend. Not only will they give you good, honest answers, but you can also start to build relationships with the people that you'll soon be calling your neighbors. Okay, so there's my list of 10 steps to take before you close on your home. Hopefully, you found my list of the top 10 things to do before you move into your home useful. Once you've moved into your house, you'll want to watch my video, The Top 10 Things to Do After You Move Into Your Home. I'll put a link to this video below. As I mentioned earlier, this is my 250th video. That means I have loads of videos to help answer any of your real estate related questions. So as promised, here's a short list of recommended videos to guide you through the process of buying, selling, or investing in real estate. The best way to make money in real estate. When should you list your house to make the most money? Why the housing market won't crash. The guide for buying a new construction home. If you're planning to move to Utah or you already live here and you're looking to buy, sell, build a home, or invest in real estate, I'd love to talk with you. Please feel free to contact me directly. If there's something that stood out to you as being helpful, if you have questions, or if you think I left something out, please help the community by commenting below. Sincerely, I want to hear from you. If you know someone who's preparing to close on a home of their own, please share this video with them. And please don't forget to hit the subscribe button below and ring the bell to be notified each time I post new videos. Also, you can find me on Instagram at Ty the Real Estate Guy. If you found this information helpful, please give me a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to ring that little bell below. It'll make you feel good.